you want a car, we're gonna name that that's a goal. Don't put your car in the same category as Martin Luther King when he said, I have a dream.
This is why I think 10-year plans are almost useless.
Nothing can stop you. The only thing that can stop you is you. No situation, no circumstance, no piece of adversity can define your life. Never let a circumstance.
I wake up every morning.
Espresso, keep me going.
I wake up every morning.
Rise and shine, it's espresso time. So let's start your day off right together. Grab your coffee and sip on today's message from Eric Thomas. Also, if you want to learn how to have more confidence, check out my 254 confidence series. It's free. The link to join is in the description below.
Even if you're my closest friend, I have boundaries. Mm.
If you're going to get to the next level, you're going to have to give up something, right? When I've been telling you to get that goal, get that dream, and I've just been telling you drive it and drive it and drive it and drive it, what I've been talking about is consistency.
Here's the deal. You, from now on, if it's something personal, call it a goal. For real, let's get the terminology right. If you want a car, we're going to name that's a goal. Don't put your car in the same category as Martin Luther King when he said, I have a dream. Don't put that in the same category. That's a different category. If you're trying to build your business portfolio, that's a goal. When you use the word dream, now you are changing other people's lives. When Dr. Martin Luther King said, I have a dream, he already had a PhD. When he said, I have a dream, he was already a minister at Ebenezer Baptist Church. When he said, I have a dream, he already had a car. When he said, I have a dream, he already had a wife. When he said, I have a dream, he already had children. When he said, I have a dream, he had already won the Nobel Prize. When he said, I have a dream, he had already met with the president. When he said, I have a dream, he was already one of the most influential people on the planet. When he said, I have a dream, he wasn't talking about himself, he was talking about you and I. And so I want you to redefine, when you say money, you say goal. Say, I have a goal. I have a target. When you say, I have a dream, that's beyond you.
This is why I think 10-year plans are almost useless. Because if you are chasing down your dreams, then your goals will change so many times over the next 10 years. Think back to who you were 10 years ago. Take today's date and imagine yourself 10 years ago. Could the person who you were 10 years ago accurately predict what a great life would be for you right now, today, 10 years later? If you've had any kind of growth over the past 10 years, then it's a no. It's a no way. You've grown so much that the person 5 years ago, 2 years ago, let alone 10 years ago, has no idea of what you're capable of. And so the danger of creating these 10-year goals for yourself is you can hit your 10-year goals. You can have a goal and hit it in 10 years. I just think that it's small compared to what you could do. Because if looking back 10 years, the 10-year younger version of you could not actually predict what would make you happy right now, then what makes you think that you right now can create a great plan for you looking forward 10 years? You can't, and that's the best. Now, I don't think goals are useless. I think goals are great. I think goals are a stepping stone along the path of your dream. You have to just make sure that your goals constantly align with your dream. So look at my business as an example. I want to help 1 billion entrepreneurs. I want to solve the world's biggest problem, untapped human potential. Like, it's never going to happen. I love it. It's never going to happen. People ask me, how am I going to measure the 1 billion entrepreneur goal? I'm not. I don't want to. I'm not trying to. The point of putting that number down is just to change the way I think about things, because doing one-on-one coaching all day long isn't going to help me get to 1 billion, right? I want to do work like this, like videos that have the potential to reach tons of people. I want to write books that have the potential to reach tons of people. I want the work that I do to have the potential to have massive reach and leverage. And so having that big dream in the back of my mind just aligns my actions. That's the whole point. Your actions have to map to your ambitions. You say you want this, but you're doing something else. Look at your calendar, look at your habits. Success equals habits. Do your habits. If you look at those habits and you did those on a consistent basis, would it lead you closer to moving to your dreams or not? And for too many people, it's not, and that's the problem. So the point isn't even to reach your dream. The point is to make progress towards your dream. The point is to have something so big that you never accomplish it, and you wake up every day and you go out and attack it. I'm gonna give you a 3-step process that I think will help give you more clarity over this. Step number one is identify your dream. What is your dream? What is the thing that you want? You do not want to accomplish your dreams. You do not want to reach the island. You want to swim forever. One of my favorite stories is Ted Turner. His father became a millionaire and then killed himself because his goal was small. He hit his goal and he got depressed. How many times have you hit your goal and then felt bad? Like, yeah, I hit my goal. I'm like, oh, now what? Because you don't have a dream. What's your dream? You gotta be shooting for something way bigger. And so Ted Turner said, I'm gonna go have a dream that is so big that I will never accomplish it, because he didn't wanna end up hating his life and maybe killing himself like his father did. What is your dream? Step number two is make it bigger. Make it bigger so that it will never happen. Make it so big that it never happens. I think that does two things. One, it's motivating that you're on this path to do this amazing quest. You're on this crazy big path that's never gonna happen. You're worthy of taking on massive dreams, right? Trying to make a dent in the universe. You're on that path, you're worthy. And two, I think it also releases some of the pressure. You're never gonna get there anyway. So just get up and keep going. There's not this pressure that you have to hit it by the time you hit X age, right? It's every single day waking up and chasing it down. So figure out how you can make your dream so big that it will never actually happen. And step number three is, what starfish will you save today? It's taking action. So there's a quick story about this tsunami that washed up all of these starfishes onto the beach, and there's millions of starfishes all over the beach. And then there's this boy who's taking a starfish off the beach and throwing it in the ocean, and taking another starfish and throwing it back in the ocean. And this guy walks by and says, what are you doing? You're never gonna save all the starfish. And the boy said, you're right, but I can save this one. And he throws it back in the ocean. That's what you should be doing. It's not having this dream is so big you're never gonna accomplish it, and like, oh man, this sucks, I'm never gonna accomplish this, so why even try? It's like, no, I can help people. I can get one step closer. Even though you can't save all million starfishes on the beach, you can save 20 or 40 or 100 or 1,000 or 10,000. You can start to make a dent in it. That's the whole point. And so yes, it's having a dream. Yes, it's making it so big that it'll never happen. And then the third step that's so important is you got to do something, right? You do something this week. What starfish are you going to save this week? What action are you going to take this week to get one little tiny step closer to actually making that dream come true? Now, I've got a really special bonus clip that I think you're going to enjoy. But before that, question of the day, I want to know, what starfish are you going to save this week? Let me know in the comments below.
I am not here for me today. I'm here for every one of you all, because I kept going because I knew the day would come when one day I'll be standing before a group of children and tell them, regardless of what happens to you in life, regardless of the adversity, regardless of the opposition, regardless of the trial and tribulation, nothing can stop you. The only thing that can stop you is you. No situation, no circumstance, no piece of adversity can define your life. Never let a circumstance define you. You see, I know something about you. I can speak from a certain place. I know something about you without even knowing you. I know if you wanted to come into this school and do what you had to do, you can do it. I know if you wanted to go into a classroom and get straight A's, you can do it. I know if you wanted to go to college, you can do it. I know that you can become whatever it is that you want to become. But it's like that quote, you can lead all rush to water, but you can't make them drink. You see, I can tell you all the right things. I can stand up here and say a presentation. But if you walk out of these doors and you don't apply it to your life, what good was it? You see, I'm not so concerned with, you know, you having dreams, you having goals. I'm concerned with the process. Because a lot of people want the prize, but not many people want the process. A lot of people have the will to win, but few people have the will to prepare to win. The process is more important than the prize. The process is more important than the product. And what the process is coming into this building day after day, giving everything you got and molding yourself into the individual that you need to become in order to make those things happen. You know the reason you set goals? The reason you set goals and the reason you have dreams is not for the outcome. The reason you set goals and the reason you have dreams is to become the person that you need to become in order to make them manifest in your life. You see, young people, the road to success is constantly under construction. With plenty of potholes, with plenty of speed bumps, with plenty of detours, with plenty of parking spots to give up. But just as if you were in a car with your mother, you find a way to get over that speed bump, you find a way to get around that pothole, you find a way to get to that detour. The only thing about life, that destination may be that goal or that dream or whatever it is that you aspire to do with your life. The one thing that I can tell you right now, man, I'm not anything special, but the one thing I can guarantee you, young people, and I'm gonna leave you with this. If you don't give up, if you don't stop, if you don't give in, nothing will defeat you, nothing will conquer you, and nothing will stop you. Never give up. Never stop, Never doubt yourself. You always believe. There's always hope. There's always somebody inside you that's stronger than anything that life can throw at you.
If you want to know how Eric Thomas doesn't sabotage himself, check out the video right there next to me. I think you'll enjoy it. Continue to believe, and I'll see you there.
You don't need to make millions to live like a millionaire.